Great Alaska EQN 9.2 on March 28, 1964. Geomagnetic observatory in the city of Kodiak was located in the distance of 440 kilometers from the epicenter of the EQ and only in 30 kilometers from the fault zone along which displacement occurred. The full-field proton magnetometer recorded several magnetic disturbances. The strongest one with intensity 100 nT appeared 1 hour 06 min before the EQ. Loma Prieta EQM 7.1 on October 18, 1989. One of the most convincing cases of the precursors was recorded before that EQ. The monitoring system of Stanford University, created for traffic noise study, operated since October 1987 at the distance of 7 kilometers from the future EQ epicenter. The system included induction coils and special computer which calculated half-hourly averages of the magnetic field power spectra in each of 9 narrow frequency bands covering the overall range 0.01 to 10 Hz. During 23 months record was normal with low noise. After September 12, 1989, anomalous signal began to appear in two frequency bands, 0.05 to 0.1 and 0.1 to 0.2 Hz and grew up to 1.5 nT. In October 5, a large increase of amplitude appeared at all frequencies with the strongest one at the lowest frequency 0.01 Hz, where it reached 30 times the normal level. On the last several days before EQ anomaly gradually diminishes, acquiescence, and 3 hours before the EQ very large amplitude appeared only at periods longer half a hertz, exceptionally large at frequency 0.01 hertz. We must emphasize that instrumentation of Stanford University which allowed to get results every half an hour is very good for LA monitoring. Unfortunately, it did not continue the operation for EQ prediction. Caucasus. Kopitinko et al. Developed three-component magnetometers for frequency range 0.005 to 10 Hz. The first instrument started the record 23 days before destroying SPH EQM 6.9 at 7.41 UT, on December 7, 1988, in Geomagnetic Observatory at Duchetti, 129 kilometers to the north from the EQ epicenter. It recorded intensive BLE which started 4 hours prior the EQ, A, B. BLE preceded some EQs in Caucasus. A. Map of seismoactive region with the sites of observation and epicenters, given by stars, of the events discussed in text. B. Final fragment off Bleer chord started 4 hours before SPH EQ and abruptly terminated 2 hours 48 minutes before it. C. Several short BLE burst records during 33 minutes before aftershock M4.0 at field stations Nick and Oni located at the distance 34.6 and 16.9 kilometers from the epicenter correspondingly. In the time interval November 14, 1988 to March 5, 1989 in frequency range 0.1 to 1 Hz 59 unusual noise like bursts of low with an amplitude well higher the background noise, 0.03 nT. And the duration ranging from several minutes to several hours, mean duration 30 minutes, were recorded mainly before the strong aftershocks. Decrease in aftershock activities and BLE activity was quite synchronous. The next strong event was Racha EQM 6.9 at 9.13 UT, on April 29, 1991, occurred at the epicentral distance of 90 kilometers from Duchetti where no pronounced BLE were recorded. It means that Duchetti is not a sensitive place for the EQs in Racha region, effect of spatial selectivity. Kopitinko's team organized BLE observations in two field sites Nick and Oni for June to July 1991, the time of Racha aftershock activities. 47 BLE with intensity up to 2 nT and duration ranging from several minutes to several hours were observed at both observatories. 23 of them were recorded 1 to 4 days before the strong aftershock M6.2 on June 15, 1991. See presence BLE bursts observed before aftershock M4.0. The distance from the epicenter to Oni was 2 times smaller than to Nick, but intensity of the signal at Nick was considerably larger, for H component in 10 to 20 times, for D in 1.3 to 2 times, and for Z in 5 to 7 times. It means strong spatial selectivity of the LA signals preceding EQ. In the conclusion we like to emphasize that magnetometers in described studies can register variations in the frequency band of 0.005 to 10 Hz, but they recorded most intensive BLE at the frequencies 0.1 to 1 Hz that differs from the result in Loma Prieta, where the maximum tends to their lowest frequency 0.01 Hz.